Well, hello and welcome to the Jyske Bank Boxen in Herning and our ongoing coverage of the 2014 Men's European Handball Championships from Denmark, the Austrian team arriving at the arena ahead of their match here this evening against Spain, the world champions. My name's Paul Bray, thanks for joining us. Someone seems to have mislaid the key to the Austrian changing room, so it's going to be they've got there in the end. Locksmith not needed. So for Austria, I'm afraid that their semi-final chance is long gone as they are rooted to the bottom. But here come the world champion Spain, arriving just shortly after Austria. That the world champions, despite losing to Denmark a couple of days ago, still very much in with a shout for the semi-final place. Arriving, needing to be very focused today. And there is a welcome sight as the line player Julen Aguinagalde comes around. So confirmation then of the upcoming match, Austria against the world champions Spain. And the team's making their way out. Well, earlier today in an unexpectedly close match, Iceland struggled to get ahead of Macedonia 29-27. Lazarov, 7 goals, still weren't enough. And that, I'm afraid, has ended, as you can see from the chart, Macedonia's chances of reaching the semi-finals, while Iceland just pop ahead of Spain for the moment with 5 points. That could all change, of course, after the game now. Hungary in 4th place. But of course, Denmark, the host nation, still top of the group with maximum points. And they will be up later on today against Hungary. The introduction of the Spanish team by the hall announcer.
8, Victor Thomas. 9, Raul Interreras. 11, Daniel Sarmiento. 12, José Manuel Sierra. 13, Julen Aguinagalde.
So the hall in marked contrast to Spain's last match here, when it was absolutely packed to the rafters as Rojas warms up. A little more sparsely populated. It'll start getting busy, of course, as the game goes on, because Denmark are up next. Spain team who bristle with talent.
13, Gideon Gadiola.
They have still 11 of the team who won the world championships
coach Manuel Cardenas,
last year in Barcelona. But under a different coach, that's Manuel Cardenas, who has replaced Valero Rivera, who's moved on to Qatar. So here come Austria, not regular attendees at major handball events. They hosted the European Championships in 2010. That was their first appearance for some time. 12, finished 9th on home soil. I would probably have to say that their high point in that particular competition was scoring 3 goals in 1 minute against Iceland at the end of their match to steal a point to help them get that 9th place finish. Very interestingly, handball, at least Austria, did take silver at the outdoor handball World Championships in 1936. That's the only medal they've managed to collect, I'm afraid, at major competitions. And there is their coach, Patrikur Johannesson, an Icelander, who takes over from another Icelander, Dagur Sigurdsson. The referees, Andrei Gusko on the left, Siraya Repkin on the right, the Belarus referees. Agreed at the European Championships in Austria that we were just talking about 4 years ago. The table officials being introduced, including the EHF supervisor and observer, Božidar Djokovic of Serbia and Wolfgang Gremmel of Germany.
From Serbia, EHF supervisor. And now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the national
going to be the anthems next, before we can get on with the formal proceedings of the game, and Austria's anthem is first.
Thank you.
And now it's the anthem from Spain.
The anthem of Spain is next. The anthem's over. Two teams who've met nine times, Spain winning on seven occasions, Austria two, but you have to go back to 2002 for the last encounter, a Spanish win, as they have been mostly recently. The last Austrian win, and that was in 1989 in the B World Championships in France. So the Austrian team, they're going to rely on the experience of Zilagi at the back. The wingers Wilczynski and Weber are on very good form, as is the line player Posch. Right back Herrmann, though, is struggling a little with a 42% shooting success rate only. But Schlinger on the left side is doing well, while Marinovic should start in goal ahead of Thomas Bauer. And there is Marinovic. 35% save rate, including a couple of penalties for the 37-year-old, who plays for Göppingen in Germany, played 125 times for Austria, and is one of six who remain from their Euro 2010 squad. On his day, he has been as good as anyone. And let's have a look then at the world champions. They've called up the line player Aguinagalde. Good news for them, he's recovered from his adductor injury and he replaces Ruesca. Right winger Tomas is their top scorer there with 22, supported by back player Cañelas, on 19. Well, the right back, Makeda, always a danger, and there is Aguinagalde. 31 years of age, 112 caps for Spain, 298 goals scored. He was in the All-Star team at the World Championships last year and also at the London Olympics. So has Patrikur Johannesson got something up his sleeve? It's an uphill struggle for the Austrians against the world champions, but the Icelander, very experienced. But Manuel Cardenas, who also coaches Wisła Płock in Poland, has taken over from Valero Rivera. And has got quite an act to follow in confirmation, as we saw earlier, that the referees are from Belarus, Gusko and Repkin. So we're just about ready to get this Group 1 match underway. Check with the table officials. So here we go then, Austria in the all-white strip, throw off the match. When we go to the wide picture, they will be playing from right to left. Spain in the navy blue outfit. They start with a 6-0 defense, then just want to see how Herrmann and Schlinger face up early on. Little handoff, Zilagi. Hugely experienced playmaker, the number 14, free throw. So free throw's taken, Zilagi. Schlinger, back to Zilagi. All the way through, oh, he was looking for Santos on the wing. Santos didn't react though, and the pass went begging straight past him. They're not a particularly good start. Spain, who came through the preliminary group stage in Aalborg, Group B, with wins against Hungary, Norway and Iceland, and then lost their opening Group 1 main round match against Denmark. Well, Aguinagalde is back. The man who was injured in their warm-up games and missed the start of the competition, fit again and back in the team, and gets the opening goal here today against Austria. Into the wing. That's a better feed to the winger, but it's saved by Gonzalo Perez de Vargas, the 23-year-old goalkeeper. That's the goal, though, at the other end, as Marinovic well beaten. So Perez de Vargas, newcomer to the Spanish team because of the injury to Arpad Sterbik, their normal first-choice keeper, damaged his left knee, as we seem to have another injury on the Austrian side, which they can ill afford at this stage. It's Vytautas Zjura. And he's looking in some pain, the 34-year-old who plays for Aon Fivers in the Austrian League. He's another one of the experienced players who's had a stint in Denmark for Vibor as well. The rest of the bench seem unconcerned at the moment. And he's going to be helped off, and that's always a sad sight because he's looking as if he's really going to struggle. Right knee or right ankle, difficult to say, probably the knee, I suspect. Let's have a look and see. Well, did he just get caught? He did. Top of the thigh, actually. It's a dead leg. Well, Spanish defence always uncompromising in that respect, and he was met sharply and has hobbled off. So Vagasreiter is taking up his place in defence for Austria in the middle, the number 22. But I'm afraid it makes little difference as Makeda starts to get his arm going. 1.97 meter, plays for Nantes in the French league. Kept the ball in play outside the area. Spain move up. Marcus Kolar is coming in defence. Good save by Marinovic, but it's to no avail. Penalties given. The foul on Viran Moros, the Barcelona defence specialist. Still on the attack here, not having time to substitute, and he's won them a penalty. Zjura may be venting his frustration after getting a bit of a dead leg earlier on the Spanish defence player. And Juan Cañellas waits to take it, the 27-year-old who plays in Germany for Hamburg. Walks up confidently. Through the legs of Marinovic. That's coolly taken. One from one for the man from Hamburg. Moving on towards his 100th cap for Spain very soon, Cañellas. So still a 6-0 defence, but for the moment, the Austrians trying to get in close, and that's inside. It won't count for Posch, I'm afraid. So a convincing start by Spain, 3-0 up inside 3 minutes, and it would be something of a surprise if Austria, who haven't beaten Spain since the B World Championships, and that's nearly a quarter of a century ago in 1989. Looking for the line, and Aguinagalde held up, and that's going to be a free throw. Tall line player, 1.95 meter, who plays in Poland for Vive Kielce. Formerly at Atletico Madrid, but when the club went bankrupt, the Poles were very happy to grab the outstanding line player. He's free on the line, didn't get the ball though. Instead, it goes the other way, and that's saved by Marinovic. Not a particularly good effort by Ugalde, and Spain tried to break out, Austria tried to break out fast, but Spain steal the ball back. Tomas in there very quickly, and Sarmiento on his feet, applauding his teammates. Spain qualified for the European Championships, top of their group, ahead of Macedonia, Portugal and Switzerland, while Austria finished second in Group 7, ahead of Serbia, but ahead of Russia and Bosnia. In their group, actually, the Russians were the one and only third-place team. There was one extra spot left because it's normally 14 qualifiers, plus the host and plus the defending champion. But, of course, Denmark are both hosts and defending champions, and so Russia, the fortunate beneficiaries of that situation as the best third-place team. patch of play being warned against Spain, and this is an attacking foul this time. Chance for Santos, and he finally gets them off the mark. It's taken nearly 5 minutes, with the 21-year-old who plays in Germany for Gummersbach plays it cleverly around Perez de Vargas. That'll just settle their nerves a little. It's just a patient build-up with Spain, no sense of huge urgency. Brilliantly done. Aguinagalde coming in fresh, having had the rest, I guess. Oh, good save. Perez de Vargas, the goalkeeper, charges out, closes the angle very quickly. Here it is, the goal at the other end by Aguinagalde. 4-1 then the scoreline here in Herning. We're on the Danish mainland in Jutland. Santos again, a bit of spin on the ball. That was nicely done by the 21-year-old. Slowly the ramping up.
Goal by Austria's number 92, Raul Santos.
Good play. So 2-4 the scoreline. But Austria, well, mission accomplished to a great extent. The main goal for them was to get into the main round, which they've done, and they did it predominantly with a huge opening day win, 30-20 against the Czech Republic, as Makeda fouls the Austrian defence. Schlinger is going to get a free throw. It's not so much that Austria defeated the Czech Republic, which was the surprise. It's the fact that they beat them 30-20. Austria then lost, though, to Denmark, and then narrowly by just a single goal to Macedonia in a real close game, but still went through at the expense of the Czech Republic. Three teams from each of the four groups going through to the main round, and now merging so that we have two groups of six, with the top two in each going through to the semi-final. Shot by Zilagi is comfortably saved by Perez de Vargas. Back comes Spain. Moros still in the attack for the moment. And we've got a two-minute suspension for a bit of pushing going on, and I think it's Zura.
2 minute suspension for Austrians, number five, Vitantas.
The four-year-old who plays for the Aeon Fivers. Played in Denmark for a little while, but that's a shame for the experienced back player. And you can just see a totally unnecessary shove in the back. Very theatrical fall, maybe, but nevertheless, it was a push. So Makeda, Entrerios, the captain in the centre, and Cañelas at left back. Formidable lineup. Aguinagalde, not sure if he meant to do that, but nearly opened up the wing. Tomas sitting deep in the wing here. Aguinagalde, second attempt, but the whistle's already gone, and it's a free throw only. A smile from the tall Spaniard. Ah, brilliantly done. It's all in the speed. Turn and shoot before anyone has any time to react. Yes, it's all muscle. Aguinagalde, who's had his position deputized by Andreu, a newcomer to the team, and Guardiola occasionally while he's been recovering. So while Spain have the extra player, they've taken the opportunity to individually mark Zilagi, who's out of the picture for the moment, trying to stay away from the fray so that he doesn't break down the move. Santos has come around to help the winger. Herman tries to go back again, the number four on the far side. Herman again. He's only scoring on a 42% rate at the moment. Herman, that's a very closed angle. And a little bit of an embarrassment for Perez de Vargas, as Robert Weber, who plays for German side Magdeburg in the Bundesliga, scores from a very narrow angle. Nice spin on it. And a long way forwards, Perez. 3-5, it's looking okay at the moment. They were determined to have a better opening than they did in their last game. That's good by Marinovic. They're opening group one match. Straight off the foot. But a couple of days ago, it was 17-9 at half-time against Iceland. Austria recovered in the second half somewhat and eventually lost 33-27, a more respectable scoreline. There's some of the Danish fans coming in. 35% save rate for Marinovic, but that's throughout the competition. So after a slow start when they were 3-0 down, they've now scored a 3-2 exchange against Spain. Here's Guardiola, used principally in defence, the number 30. Occasionally getting into the attack while Aguinagalde was recovering. Schlinger comes around, well covered by Guardiola. Weber, bit of height that got the sting taken out of it by a defender, and Galde went off on the far side, but the ball never reached him. There's the save again, and yes, it is. It looks like it may well have been, I was tempted to say, Canillas, but not quite sure if it was. He got his hand to the ball. So 10 minutes played, and it's all relatively sedate at the moment, but going along nicely for Spain as Thomas scores his opening goal today. The Barcelona right winger got a phenomenal record, 372 goals in 116 appearances for Spain. Austria bring Dominik Schmidt now into the fray. Zilagi gets on the score sheet. Defense being pulled a little bit at the moment, as is for that matter Aguinagalde, or Centrerios, I beg your pardon. Centrerios the captain, another one of the Barcelona players, five of them in the Spanish team as Aguinagalde does come in. Tries to force his way in at the back of the defense. A very high block, and Aguinagalde has scored, but I think there's some sanction coming up. Canillas on the way in, catching a hand. There it is, very high by Vagesreiter. And Aguinagalde four from four, and it's Schmidt, in fact, who's picked up a yellow card. So that wasn't the same incident. Schmidt, who's now slotted in at left back in place of Schlinger. Aguinagalde not being used in defence at the moment. Looking for the line by Zilagi, and with two Spanish defenders standing there, that was extremely risky. That'll have to come back again. Santos inside the area anyway when the throw was taken. So Fabian Posch drops in on the line. That again, the defence take the sting out of the shot and make it a comfortable save for Perez. Intercepted this time, and in an attempt to try and get it to Santos, they've thrown it out, and hard work comes to nothing for Zilagi. Well, if you play them fast, it's they're probably thinking it's a good way of breaking down Spain, catching them on the hop if you can. You've got to take every chance you can, because Spain are one of the best defenses in the world, and goals are going to be few and far between. Four turnovers suffered by the Austrians so far. Three for Spain, though. So Makeda drives in. It's not going to count. It's an attacking foul. The ball came too slow. Zilagi needed it back a lot sooner than that, and that touched the foot of Thomas. Zilagi had to check his run as Hermann just held the ball a fraction of a second too long. 13 minutes played, then 7-4. Austria have no chance of qualifying for the semi-finals anymore, but they could still spoil the Spanish party. Well, they will take probably one of the best performances they've had in a long, long time to do it. Well, that'll help. So Maximilian Hermann scores his first of the game. Nice height. Only two goals in it. But you do get the sense that Spain are coasting here. Prerios drives in. Oof, very high. Nothing given. And the wing is free. Santos doesn't get the ball, but straight down the middle instead, and that works. Courtesy of Markus Wagesreiter, the defence specialist, getting in on the act. Ball knocked away by Schmidt, but unfairly, say the referees. Markus Wagesreiter, top corner for the 32-year-old who plays for Balingen in Germany. So, team timeout for Spain. Manolo Cardenas, maybe just needing to pick up the tempo a little bit with Spain. They're just coasting it too easily at the moment. They've allowed the Austrians just to slowly peg it back, get to within one when they've had the three-goal lead. It's been a 3-1 exchange for the second time now for Austria. Aguinagalde at least, well, a confident start again after missing the first four games here at Euro 2014 for his country. Picked up an adductor injury. There are quite a few injuries, of course, that coupled with Arpad Sterbik, the goalkeeper, who's damaged his knee and is out for the competition, as is Alex Duichebaev, the son of the famous player and coach Talon Duichebaev, who's a new player in the Spanish team, a very exciting one. Unfortunately, injured himself in a warm-up game in a tournament in Spain, playing Brazil just the week before the competition started, and the Skopje player misses his first major tournament. He's only 21, so we'll see plenty more of him. So play resumes with a change of playmaker for Spain, and Sarmiento has come in. Maqueda's first shot goes straight down the middle, a comfortable save for the goalkeeper, but the ball falls into the hands of the grateful Aguinagalde, who scores his fifth goal inside 15 minutes. Julen is back. Change on the Austrian side, and they're getting stuck in there, and that's the last thing they want to do. They need a few long-range shots, but they just haven't got the same strength. But if Perez is going to gift them goals like that, I guess it's going to help Schmidt, 24-year-old who plays for the champions Alplahard. Makes it a one-goal deficit midway through the first half. Neither Spanish goalkeeper has really shone yet at these European championships. Sierra, or for that matter, Perez de Vargas. Sierra getting there. That's an attacking foul by Maqueda, who's almost too casual in a way. That's the second time he's charged into the defence and given possession away in the eyes of the Belarusian referees. Schmidt, and they're level. Well, the confident start by Spain became an amble, and now they're paying the price for it. They've got to pick up the tempo once more, and they could have a chance to go in front, courtesy of Santos. They can. Goal number three for the 21-year-old winger. Eight so far in the competition, three here against the world champions. Cardenas' timeout hasn't helped much. 9-8 to Austria in the 17th minute of this match. Three fast break goals, but not for Spain, as you might have expected, with the likes of Tomas and Ugalde charging out, but actually for Austria. Lagasreiter and Santos with a couple, making life a bit awkward for the Spaniards. Ugalde goes in on the line, and again they hit the crossbar. Oh! Beautifully done. Well, the ever-dependable Aguinagalde is there to pick up the loose ball as Ulrich Wilbeck, the Danish coach, looks on.
Goal by number 13, Julen Aguinagalde.
Lovely little broken wrist shot as he runs it off his fingertips. I'm saying, oh, it's all right. Well, 6 from 6, it's more than all right, actually, Aguinagalde. 9-all it is, then. Shot straight down the middle, And Santos throws himself into the area. And so Guardiola gets his first of the game as Marinovic, the 37-year-old keeper, looks up. Recheck the score and it'll tell him that Spain have edged back in front again as Austria call a team timeout.
Wenn jemand sagt, etwas passiert, dann bin ich, kriege ich eine gelbe Karte, das ist sicher. Aber wir müssen uns weiter auf unser Spiel konzentrieren. Und dann ist das in Abwehr um jeden Ball kämpfen. Und Abwehr ist auch diese Wille. Klar, wir sollen nach vorne laufen, Max. Aber wir versuchen, trotzdem, wir können nicht nach vorne laufen ohne Ball. Habe ich nie gesehen. In Angriff, weiter, Rolli. Rolli kommt rein. Victor, du kriegst keine Pause.
Erster
Angriff, normale Tage, dann könnt ihr einfach eure Kleingruppe machen später.
Dass du machst diese Checkpoint. Well.
Aber jetzt könnt ihr acht oder du, was du denkst. Hey, kleine Pause für dich.
Okay, okay. Let's go.
Well, Cardenas has maybe a second opportunity to try somehow and re-energize his team. It's not so much about just psychologically boosting them. He's trying to get the play sorted out.
Más consistente la defensa. Cuando viene el extremo aquí, procuramos hacer cambio. Mira, no hacemos nada marcando a un extremo y abriendo la defensa y dejando todo.
Cardenas talks about defense. Aguinagalde looks on casually around the arena, not paying attention. Again, well, that's not for me. I don't defend.
Ellos están ahora muy pendientes de los pases al pivote.
Más continuidad, tío.
So Schlinger comes back in at the left back position and Zura has gone into the center. Zura, he's struggled with his shooting a bit, 4 from 13 only for the playmaker. But Schlinger finds his range, adds to his 17 goals so far in the competition. It's all square again at 10 all, 18 minutes played. Nicely put away. Three of the Austrian team play for Bergischer, the side who are currently 14th in the German Bundesliga. Two for Ballingen, who's down in 17th. Off the post, that's going to be a free throw, and I think there may be an individual sanction as well, because
yellow card for Austrians, number 21, Roland Schlinger.
Did give a almighty shove. So Gurbindo, who's come on number 3 at the right back position in place of Makeda. And again, it's off the post. There's a lot of metal work in the attack for the Spaniards. Just need to readjust their shots.
And now plays 19 minutes in the first half.
The Austrians desperate not to have a miserable start as they did against Iceland 2 days ago. They've done that here. 3-0 down, you thought, oh dear, maybe again, but no. They are all square with the world champions. And a lot of the Danish crowd here seem to be getting behind the Austrians, going for the underdog. That's blocked, but it's a free throw. The foul on Maximilian Hermann. His twin brother Alexander is a right winger in the Austrian team, but unfortunately didn't make the final cut for the Euros. And once more, Austria in the lead. Maximilian Hermann.
And Austria leads.
Great height.
11 for Austria, 10 for Spain.
Did well, waited for Moros to be dropping again before he then shot over the top of him. And the change of keeper for Spain as Sierra comes in for Perez de Vargas. He's not done too badly, 6 saves from 17. The shot efficiency still relatively high on both sides at the moment. Oh, nicely done, Gurbindo. 26-year-old Barcelona right back. Santos came around but could do very little about it as he put the ball underneath Marinovic. So we pass the 20-minute mark. 11 all. Attacking foul by Schlinger. Moros looks up, but the ball doesn't go quite as fast as Gurbindu looks as well. Moros comes off for the substitution. And here it is again. And he runs straight into Antonio García, who's been used in defence only at the moment, together with Moros. Staying on. So, Sarmiento, García, and that's a throw-in from the side. And the substitutions are made again as back on go Moros and Guardiola, the defence specialists, and García then stays on the left back. Getting slightly ahead of myself. So the crowd trying to get Austria going here. Juras has spread wider. Well, they spread so wide that they left a hole down the middle. Guardiola puts the ball back. And Spain at the moment not pushing the fast breaks, to the chagrin of Bocas, who's now come on for Tomas on the right wing, the number four at the bottom of the picture. And Rivera on the far side has replaced Ugalde, but Rivera decides to just go in on the line. Putting the block on. Gurbindo releases the wing, but unfortunately, poor pass, which Horkas couldn't hold, and Santos has stolen it. And back come the Austrians. Schlinger. Saved by Sierra, but the ball by Weber is knocked while it's still on the ground inside the area. Spain come away with possession. So nine turnovers by Spain, six by Austria, that's high. And Spain playing almost too casually, while the Austrians are struggling earlier on as they tried to batter through the Spanish defence, which most teams struggle with doing. That's gone wide by Aguinagalde, who thought it should have been a free throw. But since the Austrians have started taking a few long-range shots, it's started to pay dividends. And there's Tomas, who's been replaced by Rojas on the right wing. Arinovic, four saves so far for Austria from 15. It's not a staggering amount. 27% save rate to Schlinger. Well, it's the timing's all wrong, unfortunately. It's stop-start. Zura. Santos, a lot of work for not a lot of gain. This time into the line, that's an attacking foul anyway. Posh turns and rams straight into the defender. And no luck for the 26-year-old who plays for Ferlach. Moros sent flying.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear you again. 11,000 spectators here get a track right now.
We've already got 11,000 spectators in, of course, Denmark playing the next match. But it means a nice atmosphere for the Austrians to play. The Austrians have experienced the full might of Danish support in this arena. They played Denmark in their second match, losing 33-29, a good result for them, actually, against the defending European champions, as Sarmiento goes down holding his neck, but the referees have waved on. And they're back in front again, Herman. Sarmiento coming back and fouling him, pulled his arm down, but he managed to put it away. Herman, one of the new players in the Austrian team, 17 internationals only. So the Sarmiento experiment ends with the captain Entrerios going back for him. Left back Cañelas is going back in as well for García. They tried that for a little while, not so successful. Great. Sarmiento has just had a miserable championship all round, scoring just 3 from 10 goals and getting barely an hour's play out of 4 matches so far. Unlike him, but I guess sometimes it just doesn't quite work. Cañelas held up. Good defending, Vagasreiter in the heart of it as ever. And Spain have been held out for 5 minutes now by the Austrian defence. just over 4 minutes remaining. It might be a high-scoring game right at the beginning with three goals in 2.5 minutes by Spain, but it's all steadied down now, and it's a bit of a slog. As Gurbindo shot a comfortable save at hip height for Marinovic, and Cardenas isn't impressed. Getting behind them as Zilagi, the experienced player, comes in. Oh, it's up the post and no luck for him in the breakout now. Rivera looks for support, decides to shoot himself and scores. Oh, that was unlucky. It shows how quickly fortunes change. You miss at one end and 5 seconds later, it's the goal at the other end. So instead of a two-goal lead for Austria, it's 12 all now. Patrick Johannesson saw something wrong with that, and there he is getting a yellow card for arguing with Siraj Repkin, the Belarusian referee. 3 minutes remaining, then it's all square here in Herning in Group 1. It's not by any means a classic game. Last break goals, 4 for the Austrians. You'd have expected that to be at least the other way around. 2 for Spain only. That's kept out. Sierra has the ball. Moros looks up for support. Rojas is on the right-hand side. And again, the Austrians working really hard to get back quickly in defence and stop not only the fast breaks, but the phase two attacks as well. Gurbindo looks for the line, but Moros, who's deputising there, is a back player normally when he does play on the attack, comes out and lets the proper player get in there, Aguinagalde. Hard effort by Entrerios, rewarded only with a free throw as we enter the last 2 minutes. It's been played very slowly this game. It's stolid, I'm afraid, but I can imagine that Cardenas is going to want the Spanish side to up the tempo considerably in the second half and start to pressure the Austrians. But at the moment, they're defending very well, Austria. They're sucking the Spaniards in. They've hit the framework of the goal more times than we care to imagine. Aguinagalde, he's got a penalty. So the Vive Kielce line player, little smile to the referee as he goes around, but little doubt about that defending inside the area by Hermann. Should be one of the right wingers, and the Austrians change keeper. And in comes Thomas Bauer. He's faced 4 penalties so far at Euro 2014, hasn't saved one yet. Plays for Lemgo in Germany. Can he do any better today? And it's not going to be the wingers. It's going to be Cañuelas. Slams it in the top. It's his second penalty of the game. I guess why change a winning combination? So a very narrow lead for Spain then. It's about to come up on the scoreboard as we come up towards the last minute remaining before half-time break. Just forgotten to press the button. It's 13-12 to Spain. Schlinger again looks for the line, well covered and stolen. Entrerios gets away, passes it out to Rivera. And no mistake, and just a bit of change of tempo, and suddenly the Spaniards look more like what we're used to. Schlinger running out of options. He got himself stuck in the defence and looked around, and no one was there. And Rivera, who plays for Nantes in France, alongside Makeda, shoots off, and Zilagi's now managed to pick himself a 2-minute suspension as well, so they'll finish shorthanded, and he's livid. Without the experienced playmaker who has weaved his magic so often for Austria, they're going to have to stay very focused, but they don't, unfortunately. They make a mistake, and the push on Rivera means that they get a free throw, and the ball sent back to be taken from the right place. Sierra passes down. We've got about 8 seconds for a quick shot. Rojas off the post again. 3 seconds maybe for the Austrians. Well, they've taken too long. So half-time then here in Herning in Group 1. 14-12 to Spain. They started brightly enough, went into a three-goal lead, and you thought, well, this is going to go the way we suspected. But Austria, to their credit, have really got stuck in. It's not been pretty. But Gilagi and his teammates have managed to suck in the Spanish team and just bog down the gate. And at half-time, it's just 2 goals the difference. So the teams go off. Makeda, 1 goal only in the first half. Let's have a look at these statistics. And very low scoring rate on both sides, hence the scoreline. 40% success rate on the attacks for Austria, only 47 for Spain. 10 turnovers by Spain in the first half and 9 for Austria. And it means 4 fast breaks have been scored by the Austrians, 3 by Spain. It's an untidy game, without a doubt. Aguinagalde, the top scorer in the game for Spain with 6, while Hermann and Santos have 3 goals apiece for Austria. And a host of other players on 2s and 1s. This is how the game's looked, and it started off brightly at the bottom there. Spain in red took a 3-goal lead, but then afterwards it became a bit of a battle of wits, and then drying up in the last 10 minutes, where it's really been hard going, in fairness. Some long-range shots for Austria, but of course 4 fast breaks in amongst that, and the wings not seeing a huge amount of action, but Santos, though, has done well with 2 fast breaks. For Spain, well, the wingers not seeing a lot of the ball either. A lot of it is breakthroughs at 6 metres, 2 penalties and 3 fast breaks, but left back and right back, just 1 goal between them. And the long-range efforts in the middle as well, not a lot of success there. So at half-time here, then Spain lead Austria 14-12. These are the shot ratios. It's not pretty reading for Austria at the beginning. Goes better in the middle, and then at the end, it's a terrible last 10 minutes, but then it is for both sides. So we'll take a short break. Join us again in just a few moments for the second half here in Herning. We'll see you then.
have some problem with some shirts. EHF cannot allow bigger crowds to have sponsors on the shirts that doesn't fit with EHF European regulations. So they may please take the shirt on or turn it around.
Welcome back to the Jyske Bank Boxing Arena in Herning. Euro 2014 coverage and this Group 1 match as Austria trail world champion Spain 12-14, a valiant fight in the first half. It was an efficient, if not pretty sight. But slowly Spain are pulling away, and that man there, Aguinagalde, 6 goals. In the first half has been absolutely terrific after coming back from injury. 6 from 7 he's been given, and of course the one he missed resulted in a penalty. For the Austrians, not quite as eminent a side, I'm afraid. Raul Santos stands out, the left winger has scored 3 goals, one from the wing, 2 on the break, and even Austria have managed to get a few turnovers and fast breaks over on the Spaniards. So the Spanish team already waiting in the middle while the Austrians wait to go on court, but their Icelandic coach Patrikur Johannesson wants a word with them. They've played almost at a sedate pace, Spain. They started quickly for the first few minutes, got a 3-goal lead. Seemed to take their foot a little bit off the accelerator, got untidy and started getting sucked in by the Austrian defense. It was stymieing everything they were trying to do. And there in the middle, Schlinger, who knows some of his opponents today because he played for Ademar Leon for one season in 2006, alongside, as it happens, Raul Entrerios, the captain of Spain today, and Moros, the defense specialist, and indeed the coach of Ademar Leon at the time was none other than Manolo Cardenas. So the coach obviously thought highly enough of him to hire him, although that said, he only lasted one season in Spain, never got settled, and eventually moved back to Austria and then now to Balingen in Germany. So for Marinovic, so far in the game, 6 saves from 19, 32% save rate. Sierra, replacing Perez late in the first half for Spain, has made 2 saves from 3 shots. So here we go then. Spain throw off this second half, leading 14-12 against Austria. Crowd getting bigger and bigger, and the anticipation rising. Well, the defense on that occasion stood still, and Cañelas rather helps himself quite comfortably. Aguinagalde holding back one side of the defense. And that's comfortably taken by the German-based back player. And so in the second half, with the extra man, because they're still serving that 2-minute suspension for Zilagi that came just before the break, Thomas has pushed up in a very deep 5-0-1 defense by Spain. But it's given a bit of space at the back. Dominic Schmidt with his second. It was a clever run because the back player went straight past him and ran in on the line, flattened the defense a little bit, just long enough. Cañelas into the wing. That's nice play. Thomas, and even his counterpart for the same position in the team. Bocas applauds him. Delightful chap he is, Victor Thomas, the right winger for Barcelona. 116 internationals. They are back to full strength again in Austria, and Fabian Posch can resume on the line. But now Zilagi won't come back in. So Zura in the centre, Hermann at right back. Schmidt waiting to come in. to the line. Oh, just too far, what a shame. Right idea, poor execution. Entrerios looks to the wing, but that's not a great pass, and Thomas brings the ball out. Entrerios left sprawled in the middle of the defence. Rivera just tests a little bit, runs in behind while Aguinagalde is still coming on. Good play, and there's a bit of an angle there for him. Oh, and again, the woodwork. I was spared at half-time and I got a measuring tape and got on and checked that's the right dimensions. They've hit it so often. So, the crowd getting behind the underdogs. Fabulous picture here in the Easter Bank box. Seats 14,000. When it's in full roar, you can barely hear yourself think. Looking for the line. He was lucky there. That was meant to go to Santos, but it came off Thomas, and it's going to be a throw-in from the corner for Austria. So, 3 minutes in. Brilliantly done. Well, Schmidt's found his range. The 24-year-old who plays for the Austrian champions, Alpla Hard, is shooting hard. Canielas, Entrerios, looking for the wing, and again he's sent flying. There's the shot again, lovely action. Aguinagalde right down on the bottom there, he's coming around, going in the opposite direction. Play set up, Thomas comes around. Two on the line now, there's a bit of space. There's a little bit more pace as well in the Spanish attack. Into the wing by Rivera, it's a free throw. That's a shame, just as they opened up the wing. Sireya Repkin gets a little bit of an earful from Makeda as he goes towards the center. And Aguinagalde pushed out then, told that's where you're taking it from. Makes absolutely no difference whatsoever because Canielas had his eye on the back of the goal. And Aguinagalde holds back two defenders. And a three-goal lead now for Spain. Focas in the discussion with Rivera. Slight problem with the clock, I think. It's fixed. So Aguinagalde, what a great comeback by him after his injury for the Viva Chelsea line player. Coming in at the expense of Ruesca, and a change for Austria as Thomas Bauer goes into goal. He's only played 40 minutes out of four matches so far. With Marinovic struggling a little bit, well, why not give him the chance? They pull one back though. Weber, 28-year-old, plays for Magdeburg. So 5 minutes into the second half, and still the Spaniards just can't pull away from these tenacious Austrians, despite good shot efficiency, but it's on both sides. Entrerios goes wide, but he's got a free throw. And the Austrians defending assiduously in the centre. Zura, a bit clumsy, but that was a very hard clash. As he went into Schmidt, looks to the line, penalty, defending inside the area. Entrerios the provider, Aguinagalde the recipient, and the player fouled. All in the wrist work. So Bauer faces up to Canielas, who hasn't missed from two so far. And still doesn't. Fifth goal of the game, third penalty. Ruthlessly efficient as ever. Six minutes in then, and a three-goal lead. penalty scored by Spain so far. To try and feed through, but no luck. So Edel Müller, who was replaced, he picked up a bit of an injury, so he got replaced for a couple of games by Fulsa. He's better now, and so Fulsa's gone back out again. Going all the way through, he's had an attacking foul, no, it's not given, it's off the far post, and Hermann scores. Spaniards up the tempo, they're taking the throw off very quickly, and Entrerrios.
Let's hear you, ladies and gentlemen, here in Jyskan Boxing. Applause for the two teams.
Look again, and just beyond the outstretched arm of Sierra, and Rivera not in play on that occasion, and Entrerrios looked to the wing, there was no one there, so they've slowed it down. Still then the two-goal gap. Well, Sirer Repkin, the Belarusian referee, seeing a little bit of a tussle going on there with Zura and Aguinagalde, has a quiet word with them both. Leaves it at that for now. Oof. And Weber. Oh, saved by Sierra. Well, you might say it's a bit of justice in a way because they won the ball through an unfortunate slip by Entrerrios, but Weber. Well, the leg is right up. What's he doing? Putting it in the top, drop it underneath the outstretched leg. But of course, he doesn't have a second chance to watch the replay and check how Sierra's moving. Three saves then for the Spanish keeper. Sierra, who plays for Paris Saint-Germain in France. Raúl Entrerrios shoots over the top. He gets a free throw. Entrerrios, who wasn't picked for the World Championships last year, that Spain won on home soil. His brother Alberto, though, did play. And now it's the other way around, and not only is that Raúl picked, but he's also the captain of the Spanish team, the number nine. So free throw, the foul on Juan Cañellas, the 27-year-old. Looking to pass out again, and still the defence is holding hard, and as long as they're not getting 2 minute suspensions, they can carry on. The referees seem to be just giving them the free throws. Good save by Bauer off Entrerrios, and out come the Austrians. Looking for the line, that's an attacking foul. Schmidt ran straight into the defender. Let off for Spain. Thomas. That was never going to reach Aguinagalde. Santos has come out with it now. Gone wide, it's a penalty, pushed in the back, and I suspect it could well end up being a 2 minute suspension. The Danish team are in town, they've arrived in the arena. So Thomas, unsurprisingly, gets a 2 minute suspension for that little push in the back of Santos. As the winger goes off, then a chance for Austria to close the gap back to within one. Change of keeper, Perez de Vargas is going to go back in for Spain. 33-year-old who plays for Toulouse in France. Faces up to Vilchinski, penalty specialist for Austria. Well, made a bit of a hash of it. He scored 13 from 14 penalties in the competition. Vilchinski pretty much only comes on for that. Inspired change then for Spain, and Perez de Vargas, job done, comes back off again to finish his cup of tea, and Sierra's back in goal again. So a chance to close the gap back to within one goes begging for the Austrians. Thank you for efficiency, 38% combined efforts of Sierra and Perez. There's a Makira. Remonstrates with the referees, who are being very tolerant of the physical defense, and you can't blame the Austrians in a way. As long as they get away with it, they'll defend as hard as they're allowed to defend. Up to the referees to set the parameters. At the moment, the Spaniards aren't liking it. Cañellas. Now there's a gap. Maqueda, his second of the game. So 10 minutes into the second half, Makeda gives a 3-goal lead to Spain. Plays for Nantes in France, together with Rivera, the left winger. Ball's won by Spain. Rivera, little crossover, and beautifully done. Moros drops his wrist back and just puts it over the keeper, and rather unselfishly given to him by Rivera, who took the two defenders off to the right. He was still under pressure. So, biggest lead yet for Spain in the game. 4 goals up. You've got to wonder at which point the Austrians are going to snap, because they're playing at such an intensity that they can't sustain it, you don't think, against Spain, at least not through 60 minutes. You've got to think that the Spaniards know that, and that sooner or later they're going to suddenly start running away with this, and they're going to be a lot of fast breaks. 4 apiece at the moment. Schlinger's back on again. That's fallen nicely for Weber. 3rd goal of the game. Pass hampered somewhat by the defender's arm blocking, but the 28-year-old managed to get away and open up enough of an angle. 3 from 6, though. Still a bit expensive. So Sarmiento comes back in again, number 11 at the bottom of the picture. Normally a playmaker for Barcelona and Spain, but Entrevios, the captain, is on and takes that job for the moment. Sarmiento, who's had a bit of a lackluster Euro by his standards. Into the wing, oh, off the post again, but this time it's a penalty. Rivera fouled. Weber remonstrates to no effect. Well, was he moving or not? He may have actually been standing on the line, more to the point, I think, rather than the movement. And Rivera will be unconcerned. So can Bauer save again? Cañuelas. And he still can't. The 27-year-old Spaniard puts it away with ruthless efficiency. 4 from 4 at 7 meters. So Gilagi comes back on again. Schlinger at left back and Hermann at right back. It's the starting lineup at the back now for Austria. No luck for Gilagi, comes back again. Just 15 minutes played so far for the Austrian captain. Good save by Sierra, but it's another free throw for the Austrians as Schlinger is brought down by Makeda. By Austria. Team timeout called by the Austrians.
Diese Kampf oder diese Bereitschaft machen wir ein bisschen durch, was da rauskommt.
So, calm, Patrikur Johannesson giving his instructions to his teammates. Seemed very calm about it. Just let's not get too excited. Still only 4 goals in it.
En ataque, después, los engaños, el pivote por detrás y que venga este extremo.
6 from 7 so far, including 4 penalties. 100% record at 7 meters.
No, espera, primera acción aquí. Contra 6-0, permuta para central, Dani aquí 1 contra 1, pivote aquí y aquí Raúl ataca al 2 contra 2, ¿de acuerdo? Vale, oye, una cosa, y después la acción esta, de sacar el pivote y el extremo entra...
So the team timeout served out and the play resumes and it doesn't look at the moment at least as if Austria going to record their next win since the last one in 1989 at the B-World Championships in France. Looks like the run's going to stay with Spain for the time being, the world champions. So Edel Müller fit again and back in the team after a couple of matches out, when he was replaced by the hugely experienced Patrick Fülser, 37-year-old. He's played 213 times for Austria. But with Edel Müller fit again, Johansson chose to put him back through. That's nice! Schlinger. Scores his second goal. 31-year-old, plays for Balingen in Germany. Drops it next to the foot. So 44th minute and Spain leading. Still, but just not stamping their authority on this game. Schlinger, oof, brings down Entrerios, his former teammate back in 2006 at Ademar Leon. Former friendships put aside as Schlinger collects a 2-minute suspension. So 16 minutes remaining and now power play for Spain, and Sarmiento now takes over in the middle as the captain moves to the left. There's a gap down the middle there. He goes straight for it when he sees it. Aguinagalde to the wing. Referees wait, seeing the advantage. And it's a third goal for Valero Rivera, son of the former coach of the Spanish team. Have the same name, Valero Rivera, who brought him into the team. Father now coaching in Qatar. So 22-18. Lead they had earlier on, four goals at Spain, but still couldn't break it out. Surely now with the power play, they should be able to try and squeeze some extra mileage out of this. Santos comes down to the middle. And again, Herrmann getting in too close, so he can't benefit from running. That's better. It's a little bit stop-start, but it's getting there looking for Santos, but he was cut out by Moros, who just stood in the way. And Spain come away with it. Oh, the crossbar again! Push in the back of Guardiola. And there it is, Szilagyi shoves Guardiola down right in front of the referee. 29-year-old, who plays for Rhein-Neckar Löwen in Germany. I think it's actually been a 2-minute suspension. It is a penalty, at least, for Cañuelas. Well, he wondered at first second, was he just going to do a broken wrist and try and put it over the keeper? He was dropping down quite heavily. But in the end, he just clips it off the post. Five from five. So still 35 seconds on the power play, and now the biggest lead yet for the Spaniards, five goals. Well, and we've got an injury. Herrmann has gone down, skidded on the floor. And holding his ankle, concerned look by Virán Moros. And they both skidded, in fact, the defender Ugalde as well. And it's these advertising strips, which are just not as... don't have as much grip as the floor, and it's happened a lot earlier. In fact, Entrerios slipped on one, and there was a fast break by Santos, and that may well have been it, that was saved luckily for them by Sierra. But that's when it happens. The floor itself has got a very good grip on it, but maybe just a different surface required for the advertising strips. Crowd is ramping up. They're still not fully packed in yet. 13,000 in here. It can take 14,000 for Jyske Bank Boxen. Luckily, for the moment, this Herrmann seems all right, although he's jumping around rather gingerly. Santos. Herrmann had to release the ball. Why didn't he give it? Well, luckily, the follow-up comes good for Szilagyi. They do these nice combinations, but sometimes don't quite make the right choices. Sierra read the right way but couldn't get there fast enough. So back to full strength again, Austria. Posch races in to take his place in the middle of the defence alongside Lagerstrater. Attacking foul. Austria have it, but it's taken from the wrong place. They'll have to send the ball all the way back. Well, I'm surprised in a way, because I thought Sarmiento was being held before he left, but the call falls luckily for Wagesreiter. And Richard Buss.
That's the way to support.
He's going to bring him on. He's not. He's sat down again. So play resumes then. Hermann on the right, Schmidt on the left, and Zilagi, the captain, on the attack now. Through the legs of the keeper. Nicely done by Viktor Zilagi. He scored 804 goals for Austria and 174 internationals. Staggering record. Free throw. And Entrerios has taken a blow on the way through. Quick look and see. Well, it's not for the faint-hearted, this game, that's for sure. The Belarusian referees have allowed solid defending on both sides. And a team timeout called by Spain.
Mira, vamos a ver. Defensa. Viene este jugador aquí, este tiene balón. Podemos disuadirlo primero para que reciba lejos la distancia, lo primero. Y lo segundo, cuando ha cogido la distancia, porque no hemos hecho lo primero, salir a hacer falta, joder, no podemos jugar al blocaje.
Focus, three from four.
Una cosa importante, mira, todos los jugadores austríacos que entren aquí, a ver si tenéis huevos y fuerza para hacerle una falta clara como están haciendo ellos. Si no hay exclusiones, coño, vamos a defenderlo.
Vamos, vamos, vamos,
vamos, vamos, vamos.
Diese kleine Fehler, Dominik, dass man diese Risikopässe lieber richtig ans Gegenteil aufs Tor geht. Und wenn wir zurücklaufen, dann ist das, was sie machen, 99% besser jetzt als gegen Island zum Beispiel. Dieser letzte, dass man schafft, zurückzukommen. Und wir aber, das muss bis Ende jetzt knappen. Nie Kopf verlieren und den Angriff viel mehr. Wenn, wenn du kommst, dann können wir viel besser spielen. Aber wenn du es bist, dann spielst du, was du denkst, da, was richtig ist. Wichtig ist den Abwehr, keine dumme zwei. Aber diese Bereitschaft einfach da und Möglichkeit, erste, zweite Welle zu haben. Wir wollen gewinnen.
Austrian team timeout, and for our viewers who experience with that, German and the Spanish, hopefully you've enjoyed that as Makeda blasts through for his third. At the moment, at least, Austria are still maintaining a degree of momentum.
And Spain leads with
kind of wondering, well, at what point are they likely to snap? Are they going to just hang on right to the bitter end and just be a thorn in the side of the world champions? Zilagi. Good timing, yes! Beautifully done. Schmidt. Goal number four, but set up by Zilagi. 12 minutes to go. And save by Bauer of Makeda. They're moving the ball down fast. Hermann, oh, brilliant shot. Absolutely hammers that in. Although still limping from that earlier slip. Sierra, not even close to it. That must have clocked close to the 100 kilometers an hour. So 24-20 has become 22-24, and Perez de Vargas back in goal for Spain. And it's happened in two very quick minutes. Well, Spain certainly don't want to start slipping up here in what is a very tight group. They are still third at the moment behind Iceland, who are on 5 points. And with only one match to play, 2 days' time for these teams. Sp- Spain, who are up against Macedonia. You would expect them to take the points there, but Lazarov may have other views about that. They get themselves sorted. Rivera scores, but again, we've got another pair down, and I'm wondering if it's Aguinagalde. Is it Makeda? Well, he took a little bit of a forearm from Zura in the face. And Makeda getting increasingly angry. I'm not sure he's picked the right... Zura, I think, who caught him rather than... meanwhile, Rivera scored 4 from 4, and Makeda saying, well, he smacked me in the face. And it's just not being picked up. Cardenas still looking relatively calm on the bench. So the remaining matches then, we've mentioned Spain up against Macedonia, Austria will play Hungary, while Denmark will be up against Iceland. Victory here today would put Spain in good position for a semi-final place with Denmark. Denmark very much in control of their fate, and in fact, if they win the next match this evening, they're up next against Hungary. They will have booked their semi-final place, becoming the first team to do so here at Euro 2014. There's the incident again, and look to the heavens for Vytautas Zura. Makeda gets his own back on him. Blocking his way through. It's a free throw. Austria still in possession, and we're coming up to the last 10 minutes. Oh, good save, but still with Austria. Santos has picked it up. Perez de Vargas staying sharp. Not the second time though. Zilagi beats him. His fourth goal. And the Toulouse goalkeeper looks up rather accusingly because no one picked up Zilagi. Gave him a free shot instead of making contact with him. Two goals in it. Crowd going very quiet on the Spanish attacks, but when the Austrians are attacking, the applause rise up from this mostly neutral crowd here in Herning. Aguinagalde again, the ever dependable line player. We are inside the last 10 minutes. And it is again a lovely pass into him by Cañelas to open it up. Moros swapping with Aguinagalde on the defense. Oh! And Zilagi, two in quick succession, and this time Perez de Vargas hopelessly out of position. Put his leg out, but that was nowhere near. And the goalkeeper struggled in the match 2 days ago against Denmark. There's Zilagi, the scorer, adding to his impressive tally of 804 international goals for Austria. Spanish goalkeepers, just a 31% save rate in the game. That said, the Austrians between them managing 24%. As another free throw goes to Spain, Makeda once more blocked. They're going to know they've been in a match tonight, both these teams. They're going to wake up in the morning with aches and pains all over. In plenty of ice, and a busy masseur, I think, this evening. ...26-24. Not what we expected, I have to say, here in Herning. Makeda to the line. Didn't release it, instead he's free to shoot. Looks to the referees if to say, well, why did you pull me up now? And there's Herman, who turned his ankle when he skidded early, and getting more spray on it just to keep him going for the last few minutes. Blocked by the defense, and that's going to be a throw-in from the corner, but maybe a free throw for the foul anyway on Daniel Sarmiento, the 30-year-old Barcelona playmaker. Drives in again, very quick player, but they're up to it at the moment, but he's managed to release the ball into Aguinagalde again. And Vagasleiter couldn't cut the pass out. 8 minutes remaining. Schmidt almost riding on the back of him. Only one missed shot for Aguinagalde, and that resulted in a penalty because he was fouled. Zura lobbed across to Schmidt. Zilagi. Schmidt, oh yes! Well, the 24-year-old, relative newcomer to the Austrian team with 19 internationals, only in 15 goals before he got here, scores at 101 kilometers an hour. Spain just can't pull away. They are certainly not enjoying one little bit this hugely physical Austrian defense. Change keepers back again. Sierra has gone back in for Spain. Sarmiento. All the way through. Free throw. And Austria, for all their physical defending, have only had 3 2-minute suspensions. Aguinagalde wrestled to the ground. And a wry smile from the line player. Siraj Repkin just waves him back. Oof, slipped out of his hand just a little earlier than he meant to. Cruises over the goal. And again, I think the throw was taken from the wrong place and they've got to send it back to the keeper. So coming up to 6 minutes remaining. And it's not been a pretty game. I'll say that, but it has been a hard physical game, and Austria have just got stuck in. They had to. The only way for them was to kill the pace of the game, kill the Spanish creativity, and defend hard as they could. Saved by Sierra, the ball is loose, but picked up inside by Posch, and it's a throw out to Spain. They're trying to steady the pace, Spain, and try and build a lead, but managed to keep in the air, but the follow-up there was definitely inside the area. And the last thing Spain want to do now is just lose their focus and drop a point here. That could really be a problem for them and their ambitions of a semi-final place. Bauer. And finally, what the Spaniards have probably been claiming should have happened a long time ago, Maqueda, almost a shake of the head to say, well, Posch pushes him in the back. Santos holding him up from the front. So Posch is off. So we come up to 5 minutes remaining. It's only a free throw for Spain. Fabien Posch, 26-year-old, who plays for Ferlach, who down in eighth place in the Austrian league, takes an enforced break. The wingers go very deep now to stretch this short-handed defense. Sarmiento tries to go through, fails, comes back again. Cañelas looks for the pass to the line. They come off a foot. It's going to be another free throw. Zura getting in the way. Sarmiento, passive play being warned. Saved by Bauer. Johansson tries to look casual about it, but despite being short-handed, they've somehow managed to win the ball back. Rivera going for the far post. When Bauer, in fact, left the inside post uncovered. Just over 4 minutes remaining, but Austria are short-handed. Zilagi comes on, but he's immediately marked by Thomas. Very deep 5-0-1 defense by Spain. Santos comes out to help. There's nearly too many steps. Zilagi's managed to get away from his marker briefly. Thomas is now back on him. He's blocked by the defense this time. We've got 30 seconds to go and a bit of a tussle between Weber and Maqueda. Maqueda saying, well, I was trying to pass the ball and you were impeding me. Staying quite calm about it. in fact, the referees needed to blow almost earlier because he is impeding the free throw at this point. The whistle's gone and still. And Makeda, though, just grabs his arm and pulls him down. And Dilchinski bellowing instructions across. But Weber seems none the worse for it. But he can't complain. He started the holding and it became 6-1, half a dozen of the other. And it's just a free throw now for Spain, who have still 30 seconds on the power play and could really do with the goal now to ease the pressure here in Herning. Entrerios is on. That's going to help. Makeda vents his frustration on Bauer.
Left.
So Posch is back on again, Austria at full strength. And despite that, they continue with a 5-1 defense. Thomas, he's dropping back a bit now. It's just become a 5-1, it seems. Not so much sticking with Zilagi now. He's just floating to try and disrupt and steal the ball. Got to be careful off the post, and that's a penalty. Well, they played a 5-1 and they paid the price. Zura saw the gap and went straight in. Thomas raced back to cover. But between him and Guardiola, they closed him down. And not only that, but Guardiola has got himself a 2-minute suspension. So Vilchinski missed the penalty earlier on. So it looks like Weber, who's scored 3 from 4 so far in this competition, will step up and take it instead. He faces Perez de Vargas. Oh, coolly done. Drops it down next to the goalkeeper with a lot of spin on it. Fourth goal for him, first penalty. 2 goals in it. Still 2 minutes and 15, and Spain are short-handed. They've left the line player in. Aguinagalde is there. 2 at the back, but the wingers have to come around and help now. And in fact, it's the left wing that's come out. Thomas stays on. Oh, good save by Bauer. Aguinagalde falling, had to take the shot probably a little faster than he would have wanted. From the wing, Weber, side netting. Sierra had it covered. Spain, who just constantly changed throughout this game between Sierra and Perez in goal, just got a hand to it, puts it into the side netting. Weber had a chance to turn the screws on Spain there, going into the last 2 minutes. Goalkeeper efficiency not looking too bright at the moment, I'm afraid, for Austria. 26%, 32% is more acceptable for the Spaniards, although they've had to tinker around to get that. As Aguinagalde is fouled, he gets a free throw. Thomas runs in. Little wrist work, but it was a hard ask of Aguinagalde to turn against his shooting hand and steady himself to get the shot in. But the push gives him at least a free throw before he could turn. So Ulrik Wilbek and his Danish team waiting to come on for their match. And as he comes up on the big screen, a big cheer from the crowd here in Herning. Makeda. Thomas. Free throw. Coming up to the last minute. Entrerios. Free throw again. That's exactly what he wants. Just run the clock down. They've actually stopped it now with 59 seconds remaining. The Austrians saying this is just time wasting now by the Spaniards, who's short-handed. Which of course it is. But it's exactly what any team would do in that situation. Entrerios wisely runs it down, the Barcelona playmaker. Elios, who was left behind it to the benefit of Ruesca for the World Championships last year. A bitter disappointment for the 32-year-old. Of course, missed out on a Spanish world title. Cañelas off the post again! That must be 8 shots off the post for Spain. Into the wing, Weber! Yes! They're back within one. Sierra tries to look casual about it, but nerves are jangling now. The bench are on their feet. One mistake now, and Santos or Weber could be off on the break for Austria. Let's see how far the referees will let them run this ball around Spain. And team timeout called by Spain. And that mentally will reset the clock in the minds of the referees, they hope, but that doesn't always work. But he just needs to settle them down, Spain. 20 seconds remaining for them to keep the ball, and maybe for Johansson on the Austrian bench to decide, do I want, well, in big letters, 20 seconds, guys. Remember, you got to keep possession for that long. But for Austria, how much do they want to gamble here? Do they want to go man-to-man and risk it? That would be a bit of a gamble against what is a quick Spanish team if you give them open space. But the play that's being shown to them is in anticipation of a set defense.
Pivote juega aquí el 2 contra 2.
Se lo va a dejar recibir, o sea que cambiamos.
Permuta.
Oye, van a presionar mucho, tío, no perdemos balón.
Vamos. The buzzer goes, and it's time to deliver. Or can Austria spoil the Spanish party?
Hey, Tommy, come. Hey, hey. Links außen. Aber hey, mach extrem, dass die müssen einfach dahin, wenn nicht, dann versuchen. Aber Jungs.
So here we go then. Hold on to your hats. Steady your nerves. Spain have to keep possession for 20 seconds. Austria have absolutely run them ragged. Admittedly defended incredibly hard. Into the wing! It's saved, and time now maybe for Austria to shock them. The clock has been stopped with 6 seconds. Rivera had a chance to put it beyond the Austrians, but it's saved by Bauer. Team timeout for Austria now. He had one left. Could be handy. Well, I bet that Iceland, if they're still in the arena, must be looking on and going, well, I do hope there's Bauer who made that save. He's been used in very small measures, 40 minutes of play in 4 matches only here for Austria, Bauer. He's made 6 saves in this game from 18 shots, 33% save rate. And that last save could prove to be historic if in 6 seconds Austria can score and share the points with the world champions. And what a shock that would be. The Jyske Bank Boxen, who've been supporting the Austrians throughout, all the neutrals have gone with the underdog, but they have defended very, very hard. Spain would say almost to the limit, really, but the Belarusian referees have allowed it, and the Austrians have played with the what was being allowed. How quickly can they get the ball down? The Spaniards will wait back, I suspect, not chance it to push up. That would be simply too dangerous. So Bauer will put the ball back in play. They're saying, move up quick, the clock's running down. In fact, they've reset it. They've taken out their goalkeeper. Versus in! Free throw. Had he blown to stop the clock, I'm not sure. Or will it have to be a direct free throw? Božidar Djurković, the EHF supervisor's coming on, as some of the players getting a little bit excited. What's been given? And we've got a 2-minute suspension, I think, for arguing with the referee. Siraya Ripkin puts his hand up. The clock seems to be staying at 60, which means it's got to be a direct throw, and Zilagi is going to step up and do it. The 35-year-old with a chance to turn Spain's evening into a miserable affair altogether. 2-minute suspension, totally irrelevant at this stage anyway. It's gone to Guardiola. And so the entire Spanish team is still there. The remaining 5 players, they put all the tallest ones on, standing together. One throw. There's been one direct score already in the competition. I think it was Lecky for Hungary who got one earlier on. These are almost impossible to score, but every now and again the impossible happens. Zilagi, one throw to share the points. The referee walks off again and the tension mounts. Come on, Repkin. Oh, not a bad effort. And for Spain, a collective sigh of relief. They win the match by the skin of their teeth. 28-27, the brave Austrians threw everything but the kitchen sink at them in defence. Well, Patrick Kuria-Hannison can be proud. His players have done really well. A semi-final place was not on the cards for them. There's a throw again. Well, about 40 centimetres wide. And the Spaniards, well, they don't really look like they've just won the match, do they? Here it is again. And the 35-year-old gave it an almighty crack. Sierra had it covered, but you could see him almost breathing out as it went. So Entrerios and his team straight through in what has not been a pretty match, but where it's been a match all about Austrian relentless defending. They've pushed the boundaries throughout the game, played it really well. They've stifled the Spanish creativity. To the extent that we had 9 fast breaks already at half time, and then in the second half it just completely dried up. No more fast breaks. It was just bringing the ball up slowly, getting caught up in the defense, and then moving it back slowly. So Maximilian Hermann, with 5 goals from 6 attempts, gets the man of the match award for the Austrian team. Well, he's managing a smile, the 22-year-old, and so he should. One of the newcomers to the team, bright future for him. Hard from Zilagi and his teammates. And Aguinagalde, quite rightly, with his 8 goals from 10 attempts, gets his man of the match award on his first time back. The irrepressible line player from Vive Kielce. And those goals proved absolutely crucial in the end. Well, the most unexpected of results here in Herning, as the tenacious Austrians ran it to the wire with Spain, eventually going down 27-28. Let's have a look at the stats then. And the attacks, well, it's roughly 50-50 around there in terms of the success rate on their attacks. Field throws, the Austrians more successful than the Spaniards in the end, 63% to 56. And then 14 turnovers for Austria, 13 for the Spaniards. So Aguinagalde, top scorer in the game for Spain with 8. Cañelas on 7, while Schmidt got 6 for the Austrians. Hermann, their man of the match, getting 5. This is what the game looked like. Very slow in the second half. And then in that last 10 minutes, we had a 4-minute spell with no goals. And the Spaniards just couldn't break away. Good play on the right wing in the end, 5 fast breaks, that's all in the first half, and then it's everything down the middle with only a couple of goals coming on the left for Austria. For Spain, good wing play, straight down the middle, the left and right back not seeing much of it, and then 5 penalties, 4 fast breaks. Well, what a game it has been. The tension absolutely palpable here in Herning, but next up, of course, the Danes are warming up, and this is the scoring ratio for the Austrians. Very high in the middle there, you can see, while for the Spaniards they struggled in the first and the last 10 minutes of the game with very low success ratios, and that's where the Austrians got stuck in and came back. They didn't like that tough defense. So this is what the group looks like then. Denmark, who are about to play against Hungary, top of the group on 6. Spain join them there on 6 for now, with Iceland on 5 points, and Austria, despite this great performance, still on 0. Hope you've enjoyed the game. Join us again, I hope, for the next one. But for now, from me, Paul Bray, goodbye.
So they may
bin ich kriege ich dann gelbe Karte.
No me faltes, que por eso es lo que se sabe caer del día.
Venga, vamos, chavales, va.